Hello everyone, this is Rick with Cybermedics, and we're here today to talk about System Restore and Recovery Drive from the Advanced Recovery Tools in Windows. We'll walk you through the process of creating a recovery drive. We'll show you how to open System Restore, configure, and create a Restore Point, and ultimately have Restore Point and Recovery Drive available for you to recover from a corrupted system. So the first thing we'll do is start the System Restore. Come down to the Start menu, create System Restore. And if you have the shadow copy error problem with System Restore, there's a video link above that will walk you through the process to fix that. So the first thing we'll do is we'll click Configure, and we'll turn on System Protection if it's not already on, and then decide how much hard drive space you want to allocate. The more hard drive space you allocate, the more restore points you will have available. Click OK. Come in here and select Create. Provide a name. I normally give it a date at the front end and a note to explain why I created the restore point. So create, creating restore point, successful. Okay, we'll close that. Now we'll go through the process of restore. So we'll select System Restore. It defaults to the most recent restore point. You can choose a different one. Next, you may have additional restore points available. The description may be important because it'll allow you to select the one that's most appropriate to fix your current problem. All right, we'll select this one. And before you restore, a little word of warning that even though you have a restore point, when you go to restore it, it could corrupt your Windows operating system. So there's no guarantee that it's going to come back in an operable form. That's why it's important that we go to the next step, which is how to create a recovery drive. So select recovery drive, open. Now the recovery drive will allow you to have a bootable system with utilities to restore your computer. And we'll get into the details as we go through this. So it's going to back up your system files to recovery. Select next. And it can take a while sometimes for the recovery drive program to launch. It's noting that you need at least 32 gigabytes on the USB drive. I'll put the drive in the computer now. Explorer launches and shows the drive is here. We'll close this window. Now the recovery drive acknowledges the USB is available. And we'll select next. It's telling you everything will be deleted, so it's going to be reformatted. So make sure that it's the drive you want to dedicate for this purpose. And this also can take a little while to do. Copying the utilities, backing up system files, copying the operating system, and recovery drive is ready. Now, before we click on finish, I have the drive in the system. It's going to reboot into the recovery drive. You want to make sure that you have configured your BIOS to be able to boot from a USB drive. So you need to research that before the need to use the drive occurs. You'll see over here very quickly F2 and F12 boot options and BIOS were on the screen, and it goes by real quick. We'll select troubleshoot from here. We'll go into advanced options, and you have six different utilities that you can use to try to fix your system if it's not booting properly. I will say the uninstall updates is probably the one to start with, because most Windows startup problems occur after an update from Microsoft. So if something was working properly and then all of a sudden you go in the next day and it's not working, you probably had an update installed, and if you roll that back, most likely your problem will be fixed. In the future, we'll do a more detailed video on all of these troubleshooting options. That concludes our video demonstration of System Restore and Recovery Drive. We walked you through how to create the recovery drive, showed you how to launch System Restore, configure it, create the restore point. And now you have a recovery drive and restore point in case your operating system will not boot properly. If you have any questions or comments, please post them below. Hope you will consider subscribing and have a great and wonderful automation day.